أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم How are you students? I hope you all are fine and safe at your home place. Inshallah, Ameen. I'm your teacher, Ms. Sobhya Naz, of your subject History Geography, Class 7. Today we will discuss your second chapter of your geography section, Climatic Regions of the Muslim World. Let's come to the discussion about your chapter subheadings. Your first one heading is deserts. What are deserts? Note that deserts are often infertile because of the nature of soil as well as the lack of moisture. It is largely sand without any of the humus that makes it fertile. And even if water is supplied, is from some very deep artesian wells in deserts in Chile and Australia. Regenerating the soil is a difficult and lengthy process. It is not practical just to import good soil from elsewhere. Far too vast a job, although Abu Dhabi has done this on a small scale. Hence, the land has to provide its own soil. This is done in some places by growing plants in small pockets of soil, and then as the leaves fall on roots. Humus is made, but this is very tedious and long-term process. In any case, it is often not just the absence of water and poor soil that makes the desert. It is the climate, searing winds, and extreme temperature. The winds keep the sand moving, so that it is difficult for plants to survive even in their own pockets of soil. I hope you all are cleared with the heading of desert, that what is that desert. Now come up to your next heading, that is semi-deserted and scrubland. I will tell you about this heading. Low growing trees or bushes such as tamarisk and acacia are found here, with some plants that grow in tough ground conditions. They have little value as timber except as firewood. They usually have thorn to minimize the depredations of grazing animals, and a small vestigial or modified leaves to minimize water loss, and deep roots reaches any water available. The vegetation is coarse and tough and of little use to animals wearing carpets. Carpets are made both in factories and as a cottage industry. These factories made carpets exceed the hand knotted products, 4 or 5 to 1 in number. Designs are very traditional and from neighboring countries, but today for the Western market, contemporary patterns are being produced. Children as young as 5 years old are employed in the villages. Their smaller fingers are said to be more nimble than those of adults, and their knotting closer. The closer together the knots, the higher the quality of carpet. Perhaps, if suitable, talk about child labor, which is the cause of considerable criticism internationally. What would these children do if they are not making carpets? They will end up doing a job as adults. So should they not start young? Do they need a formal education? These questions to be answered. Now your next heading is tropical grassland. Let's discuss about this. The moderate to small amount of rain that is average for this region is still more than double that of most parts of Pakistan. The majority of tropical grasslands are in the southern hemisphere, most in southern Africa, But small areas are also found. The land has been cleared and irrigated and is used for intensive cultivation. The tropical grasslands are the big game areas in Africa, which now support many thousands of people in the tourist industry. Shooting with cameras and not guns, the many animals of the region have evolved, adapted to their environment. The tawny color of the lions merges into the color of tall grasses in the dry season, zebras and leopards' skin making mimic the shadows of grasses. Elephant and rhinos have defensive armor and strength and do not need camouflage so much. Giraffes with their long necks can see over the tops of the tall vegetation and spot the approach of predators. Many kinds of deers have to rely on speed, but life for most of them is just chance survival. Travel agents may have brochures of safari holidays, collect these and make different charts of it. Now, your next heading is tropical forest. Pakistan has no example of a tropical forest. The heat and moisture are critical, as the actual soil is usually not particularly fertile. Most of the fertility coming from the rotting leaves on the floor of the forest. The forests are naturally evergreen, but leaves too have to be replaced. Because the fertile layer is generally shallow, the tree roots are usually near the surface, naturally with their great height, in the struggle to reach the light. They are often very unstable. When densely packed, they get some support from one another, but some varieties of trees have developed buttresses, supports on the lower trunk to strengthen them. Vast areas of Amazon tropical forest are being cleared illegally to grow crops and also for stock. 11 million hectares have been cleared for cattle ranching. The farmers have found the result disappointing, as the fertility is short-lived and with exposure to the continual rain. Severe erosion takes place. The canopy of leaves in the natural forest breaks up the force of the rain and allow it to trickle gently to the ground. Also, the removal of millions of hectares of virtually uncharted forest is perhaps removing some as yet unknown species, which will be vital medicinal value. One has to think of Ingona tree from this region, which was for many, many, many years the only remedy against malaria. We do not know what we are discarding. The clearance of rainforest is saving a savage cycle. The cleared land soon become relatively infertile and more has to be cleared to accommodate the cattle and crops. Your next heading is temperate desert. Now, I will tell you a little bit about it. Considerable areas of Pakistan fall into this group. It is on the verge of practical cultivation, but with fertile and irrigation, it can produce reasonable crops. These are dry lands, getting 50 to 300 millimeter rain a year, but not as warm as hot deserts. In the Muslim world, most of Iran, Afghanistan, Central Asia states and parts of Pakistan belong to this climatic regions. Naturally, they have small trees, especially Acacia and Cassia, with many coarse plants and grasses. Traditionally, these lands have been the regions of nomadic people with their herds of animals. Today, with much irrigation and fertile, many are growing reasonable crops. Uzbekistan, the whole of which is temperate desert, is the fifth largest cotton growing state in the world. Although this has almost drained the Caspian Sea, from which most of the water has been taken. Now let's come to the next heading, that is Mediterranean climate. A very limited area falls into the one of the most productive climates in the world, producing so many high value crops, highly situated for the sophisticated markets of Western Europe. Even rice is grown widely in Italy and Egypt on the fringe of the Mediterranean zone. It has a very large cotton growing base. In fact, Egyptian cotton has been highly prized for its long staple fiber. Now let's come to the next heading, that is temperate grassland. Temperate grasslands. These are the great grain growing and livestock raising regions of the Muslim world. Temperate climates are variable because they are flexible in the crops that can be grown from the rich grassland for livestock to grains to a wide variety of fruits and vegetation. These areas where it is reasonably warm but with fairly low rainfall, about 400 millimeter a year, the natural vegetation is long grass with small shrubs and other plants, but in most Muslim world these have been cleared for general farming. Cereal crops such as wheat and barley are grown, but with irrigation of a wide variety of other plants and fruits are also produced. This climatic region is excellent for the rearing of animals, especially livestock. Now let's discuss next and the last topic of this chapter, monsoons. The climatic regions is confined to the Indian Ocean and concerns mainly the subcontinent. There are relatively small areas of a similar climate in South America, America and the Caribbean, as well as very tiny areas on the west coast of Australia. Surprisingly, monsoons are by geological standards relatively recent. They are thought to be a product of rising of the Himalayas and the Tibetan plateau starting 20 million years ago. These eventually affected the wind patterns, and it is believed the monsoon began about 6 million years ago. Once again, Pakistan seems to have been unlucky, as the full force of the monsoon and particularly the rain is modified by the pattern of the wind diversions. I hope you all understand this chapter really well, inshallah. Till your next video, Khuda Hafiz, take care.